lumen, as it's called, will become smaller, and you can't really get much through that, which is... Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for tuning in, and this one has been actually requested by some of you over on my Instagram, and that is what types of surgeries or procedures you can have if you have Crohn's disease. Now, as you know, I have Crohn's disease, but to try and give an overall picture of what surgeries that can be done, I'll also talk about those available for ulcerative colitis, which just happens to be more or less exactly the same for Crohn's disease. So as usual, make sure you hit that subscribe button, give this video a like or a thumbs up, and feel free to leave a comment of what other videos you'd like to see or topics you'd like me to cover. You can also check out my social media pages. You can find the links in the description box below. And also you can sign up to my newsletter, where I send out exclusive content such as tips and tricks on living with Crohn's disease, which I just send out to my subscribers only. So if you don't want to miss out on any of that, you can find the link in the description box below to my website, where you can sign up to the newsletter. Right, so modern medicine is amazing, and there has been so much development, not only for the drugs that are used to treat IBD, but for the medical practices or techniques used in surgery to manage not just Crohn's disease, but all other diseases as well. So the way which this advancement has helped with IBD is that the types of surgeries where they remove large sections of the bowels are becoming less common. But surgery does remain an important part or an important treatment option in combination with the medication you take. So the use of surgery to treat IBD, it has come a long way, as I said, because of the advancements of modern medicine. And for the large majority of people who do have IBD would need an operation. So everything that I'm going to talk about is just going to be a brief description of what these procedures involve. So if you do have any questions or concerns about if you might need one of these, or if you're going to have one of these operations soon, it's best to talk to your IBD team, who will be best placed to advise you, as every case is different. So I'll start with what's known as a strictoplasty, because I have actually had three of those. I've had two strictures during the first few years of my diagnosis, and I have just recently had another stricture dilated. So if the stricture is quite short and accessible by colonoscopy, it's possible to have something called an endoscopic balloon dilation. This is just a fancy way for describing the use of a tube that's placed up your bottom to go to the area of the stricture, and using a balloon to just inflate it, so it can increase the opening of the stricture. Other times you may need an operation, as the problem with strictures is that they can cause blockages, and in some cases the surgeon would have to open up the narrow section of the intestine. And strictures could be a reason as to why you feel abdominal pain, as food can't pass through the narrowing. So this type of operation just helps widen the narrowing. So if you think about your intestines being like that big, for example, a stricture is a narrowing, so the lumen, as it's called, will become smaller, and you can't really get much through that, which is why when food tries to go through there, it can be quite painful, especially if there's a backup of food. Now, the trouble with strictures is that they can be any length and can occur anywhere, so you could have strictures in different places, some of them quite close together, or others in different areas of your intestines. If some of the strictures are very long, or if there are many quite close together, you may have a procedure called a resection, where they just cut out that length of bowel and attach the two healthy bowels together, and that joint is called anastomosis. Next on the list is a procedure known as a limited right hemicolectomy. There's some big words here, so bear with me. What you need to know about this is that the large intestine is split into sections. So you have your ascending part, your transverse part, your descending part, and the rectum. Okay, so the right-hand part of your large intestine, which is located here, is known as your ascending colon. And if your IBD affects this part of the colon, this is the part that will be removed. Now, depending on which part is affected with IBD will depend on how much is taken out. Some cases, you may have an operation called a colectomy, which involves removing a large portion, if not all of the large intestine, and so usually leads to you requiring something called a stoma. If you do end up having the majority of your large intestine removed, what will happen is that the surgeon will take the end of your small intestine and pass it through an opening in your abdominal wall, creating what's called an ileostomy, which is where they will put a stoma bag to collect any waste that comes out of your small bowel. And in some cases, your rectum or the last part of your intestine can be disease-free. So in these cases, what happens is the disease portions will be removed and the small intestine will be joined with whatever's left of your large intestine. This is known as a colectomy with ileorectal anastomosis. Now, if the last portion of your large intestine, so the rectum, if that is diseased, then what will happen is that it will be removed, as so would your anal canal, and then an ileostomy will be created, which is known as a proctocolectomy, and this can't be reversed. So if you have this done, you will have this for life. Lastly, and it's worth a mention, as many people do suffer with abscesses and fistulas, but you can also have operations done on them as well. For those of you that don't know what an abscess is, it's basically a collection of pus, and it can look like a boil, and if they're bad enough, you may need them lanced, which is just a fancy way of saying you'll have them cut open, and then you allow the contents to be drained out. A fistula is an abnormal connection between two hollow structures, and they are usually dealt with by being drained, and so this can be done with using a specialized thread called a seton, which is just helps the fluid within the fistula to be drained. And that's pretty much it for the possible operations you could have for IBD. I think I've covered it all off the top of my head, but if there's something I've missed, then let me know in the comment section below. Or if you've had any of these operations, then I'd love to hear your experiences, so feel free to leave a comment in the comment sections below. If you haven't already, subscribe to my channel. I have more videos like this. And if you want more information on Crohn's or colitis, or if you're just interested in following my journey with Crohn's disease, then you can follow me on my social media pages, and links to all those are in the description box below. That's it for today, and hopefully I will see you next week with another video.